Okay, let's show you how this control box works now. So it automatically comes with these grid terminals, which are four for the actuators, and then two smaller ones, one for power, one for external switch, if you want to connect one, or if you want to connect it to a PLC or Arduino or a control four system, home automation system, this is where you would connect it to, simple two wire terminal. And I've already wired in a power supply. Here I'm using 12 volts, but you can use 24 volts. So left is positive, right is negative. I'm running in a separate wire from the power to go to the switch because the switch needs power. This is just a simple up and down rocker switch. And so as soon as we plug it in, it'll power up. There we go. And we'll plug in a switch. Yes, you can control it from here under the manual operation. And then we'll plug in, we'll just do one actuator for now. And the instructions are on the back, just use the QR code, scan that, and that'll bring up the instructions online. So first thing we want to do is set the update the clock, make sure you've got the time correct, as well as the date. And we want to set the actuator. So we'll tell it, first of all, what unit. So this is our 8-inch stroke actuator. So we'll tell it we're in inches. And then the length or the stroke we'll set to 0800 inches. So it's 8-inch stroke, save. So now we can run it from here. It'll extend, it'll go all the way to the end of its stroke and stop, or you can use the switch. Extend, stop, retract. And we'll show you a few other things here. Let's show you the limit switch. So you can adjust the limit switches. That's the extended position, the retractor position. Let's set it like that, save. So now when it goes to the end of the stroke, it'll just go to that position we've previously set and stop. And the readout will actually tell you exactly where that is in inches, what part of the stroke that is. There we go. And then retract it. Stop there. Now, if we also want, we can adjust the speed. So now it's come standard set at 100% of the speed. So let's say we'll leave the extending at that and we'll drop the retractor speed to 50%. So now if we extend it, it'll extend at 100% of its speed. And stop. And if we retract it, it will then retract at half the speed. Simple. If we want, we can also use a timer mode from here. There are two different timer modes, interval mode or a time mode. A time mode is where you set a certain time of day you want it to open and a certain time of day you want it to close. So this is set for 11:31, retract at 11:32, and you can tell it which number of days as well you want it to turn on and off. And you can have up to five different timer modes. Okay, now we're going to show you how to use an interval timer mode for this control box using these two utility actuators. It's very simple. So first we go to time operation, go to interval mode. We set it to say, let's say it extends after 30 seconds, or well, let's make it less than that for the video. So let's say 10 seconds, save, and then delay until retracts. So it'll get to the end. It'll wait for whatever time we set here. Let's say 5 seconds. Save, And now it's set. So it'll wait 10 seconds, then extend, then wait 5 seconds and retract. So we now have to tell the program to enable and to start the program. So we go to enable disable mode. And this is where you highlight whichever timer programs you want. So we hit interval and it's highlighted in yellow. So that shows us which modes have already been selected. To deselect it, you just press it again and it turns off. So we go to interval mode. We want to turn it on. We hit back. We hit back one more time. And you can see at the top left, it says interval mode one. And that means the program has already started and it's already started the countdown. So there we go. It's already started the countdown. It's extending. It'll get to the end of the limit switches, 8 inches. It'll count to 5 seconds and then it'll start the retracted. There we go. And in this mode, we've not adjusted the limit switches built in to the control box. We're just relying on the built-in limit switches of the actuators themselves. And same for the speed, we've not adjusted the speed in any way. But whatever we do adjust in the control box automatically gets programmed into the actuators as well. So there we go, it's as simple as that.